That's always, you know, something that can be seen in one way or the other. Now, I belong to the EORTC lymphoma group, and we are doing this, one would say personalization or risk stratification, however I want to call it, for years. So we know, you know, we have this criteria for differentiating favorable and unfavorable risk in patients with limited stage Hodgkin lymphoma. And the German Hodgkin Lymphoma Study Group have similar such criteria, which are probably easier to use and more precise and are able to guide treatment decisions, especially in this risk reduction direction. So, you know, if you have favorable Hodgkin lymphoma, according to the German Hodgkin Lymphoma Study Group criteria, you only need 2 cycles of ABVD and 20 gray of involved node radiotherapy, which is a rather limited therapy. And in this area, I would be very skeptical of omitting radiotherapy, because these are limited fields and low-dose radiotherapy. And I think it's less toxic to give 20 gray to the limited field in favorable Hodgkin lymphoma than to go on with chemotherapy that has its toxicity also. And then when it comes to patients who have unfavorable stage 1 or 2 disease, then this is going to be an interesting interplay with the shortening of more intensive chemotherapy versus giving less intensive chemotherapy like ABVD and then going for radiotherapy. So I think this is still there. There is still an interplay of what is more effective and what is less toxic, whether giving, you know, more chemo that is more intensive and then, but for a shorter period of time, or giving longer treatment, including radiotherapy. But yes, I think this is what one would call, you know, risk adaptation or stratification by patients and so on. In a way, we are already doing it, I think.